Hello guys, I'm going to show you how I scan these miniatures. First I built this this turning wheel with some toy very similar to Lego. And once I have that built, I need to put some markers, as you can see in the platform, to make the software work. You need to push the platform a little bit, then take a picture and so on until you have up to 50 pictures. So once we have all the pictures that we need, we will use this application called Autodesk Remake and upload the pictures. We wait for them to be here and then we put a name on them and we select these couple of options here. And then we need to wait a little bit to upload the pictures. And we will need to wait longer to allow the application to process the data. So what I do in the meantime is take pictures for the next miniatures. So I just and uploading, and so I do 3 or 4 in a row, and I just leave them in the queue to be processed. Once this is processed, we download it, and now we are able to edit it. As you can see here, is the first results. Are pretty good, but we need to clean up this a little bit. So the first thing that we are going to do is to remove these parts of the platform, and then we are going to use another tool we have here just to slice off the part that is below the base. We have an option here to fill what we cut off, and so the miniature won't be hollow if you look at it from the below of the base. So now we have the platform removed, we are going to keep on cleaning up this, removing these parts. Once you remove this part, obviously you have some gaps in the mesh that you need to fix. There is a pretty cool thing here, which is another tool called something like fill hole or something like that. But I prefer to use another one that gives you the opportunity of doing mostly the same thing but manually, so you can control better how the holes are supposed to close, especially here on the corners of the gaps, for example. And you select both sides and then join them, and the difference is that if you try to use the whole fill directly, the how the application interprets what you are trying to achieve is not correct, because it doesn't have the detail that it needs. So if you try to use the whole fill directly in a big hole, probably you have some bumps in the mesh and some strange thing happening. So I start using the bridge and make the hold smaller. And once I have a bit decided how I want to close the gaps, I use the other tool. So now we do the same here below the arm. First, we remove all unwanted mesh. It will require a bit of practice, but after you have done two or three miniatures, it's pretty easy. Now we go to the bridge to join these parts here. Okay, and here, for example, in the corner. Okay. And here. All right. One more. And now we go with the whole field. And here. Okay. Oops, there's one more here I didn't see before. Okay, so much better now. We can see that white thing. But if you zoom out, you don't see it. Sometimes it's not happening and the textures are merging properly, but sometimes that white thing appears, but it's okay. We have a couple of tools more here to resize a miniature and rotate it and that stuff, but I didn't manage to use it correctly. So we are going to do one more thing here, which is to decimate the miniature, which is basically to reduce the number of vertex that are made in the mesh. Okay, as you can see, I've reduced it 80%, and now we have less definition, but the final result is almost the same, and the file that they have all this information is not that heavy. We export the miniature, and what we are going to do next is to open it in Blender. I am only using Blender here to resize the miniature and to rotate it properly, because if you try to import directly into TS from this application, it appears lying. And as I try to use the rotate things on the application, but I didn't manage to make it work properly. So I import the object file in Blender. Okay, and as you can see, it's really big. I also use those squares on Blender to have an idea of the size of the miniature, and try to have some consistency from one miniature to another. And now I put these four views window and use the R key to rotate in each of them and to locate it properly into the squares. Okay, there. right size. And now we save the Blender project. And we are going to export the miniature again to this object file type. But I'm going to rename it and put a B at the end of the name to have a different version of the file, just in case I want to go back to redo something in the previous version. Okay. So that's done. Now we need to take this object file, which is basically the information of the mesh, and renaming it to text file, because the website where I am uploading this file is blocking the object file extension, so I just rename it to txt, and it works when I try to download it from TTS. And I put the name also to the texture file, which is the JPG. Sorry, and now I upload it through the FTP application to some repository there on the web. Now we go to TTS and we select some custom object, a model here, and we need to put the location of both files, one for the mesh, one for the texture. Okay, and there. And we select these options here, this one and this one. I take up cardboard because it doesn't have some reflections and looks better. Seems that I mistype the texture name. It was now. All right, I think, yeah. Now we have the correct name. So this is it. And that's the process. Basically, it takes about 15 minutes to if we are not counting the time that the application takes to process the data, 15 minutes to create each miniature. I really like the results, and you only need to have that platform to turn the miniature, a good webcam to take the pictures, and that's all, because the application has a free option that you can use for this purpose. And of course you need to have some miniatures to scan. And that's all. I hope you like it and you join the scanning team, and we can have a lot of miniatures to play in TTS. Okay, bye bye. This is who we are.